Bureau of Prisons offers four programs that will actually reduce the time of incarceration of an inmate. It's better if the defendant will contact us before he becomes an inmate, because it's much easier at that time. But we've had tremendous success for getting into all four programs, even from inmates already in prison. The first program is kind of our namesake program. It's called the Second Chance Act. Now, the Second Chance Act is also a federal law. It was signed by President Bush in 2008. It was March or April of 2008. And we are the company that developed the Second Chance Act in June of 2008 for the whole industry. So it's pretty much our namesake program. And if an inmate is eligible, or if an inmate is eligible for the Second Chance Act program, it could allow him to leave prison up to 12 months early. Part of that time will be spent in a halfway house. Part of that time will be spent in home detention with his family. Now, when he gets to home detention, he may have to wear a ankle monitor. He may not. Again, this is totally up to the probation officer. It's up to the probation officer, but he'll be able to go to church. If he has a job, he'll be able to get a job. He'll be able to go to doctor's appointments. He probably will have a curfew, and he'll have a radius that he can't go out of, but he's at home. He's in his own bed, he's with his children, he's with his family, and he's not in federal prison. So it's a tremendous program. This is an anti-recidivism program. The Bureau of Prisons does this because when an inmate gets out, they don't want that inmate to commit another crime and recidivate, go back to prison. So it's a tremendous program for that. One of the most popular programs also is they call it the RDAP program, RDAP, which stands for the 500-hour Residential Drug Abuse Program. Now, this is for not only illegal drugs, but alcohol, and also prescription drugs that are abused. Oxycodone, Oxycontin, Percodan, things of that nature. This program is an intense program. It's 500 hours. It's classes 4 days a week, usually 3 to 4 hours in the morning or 3 to 4 hours in the afternoon. And this program helps the inmate to realize his substance abuse issues and to overcome them in the process of this program. Like I said, it's a very intense program, but they give incentives. The incentives are up to a maximum of 12-month sentence reduction and 6 months in a halfway house. So that's an 18-month reduction in the time you're in prison. The sentence reduction varies as the length of your sentence. So if you're up to a sentence up to 31 months or up to 30 months, you get 6 months off sentence reduction, 6 months in a halfway house. If it's 31 to 36, you get 9 months off and 6 months in a halfway house. And if it's over 37, you get a full 12-month sentence reduction and 6 months of halfway house. So you're going to get 12, 15, or 18 months off your sentence. The third program is called the Commutation of Sentence Program, which is actually a presidential pardon. And a lot of people don't know this, but President Obama did a huge number of these in his last year in office, or over 500 of these. So, and we have been very successful in the Commutation of Sentence Program. The final one is called the Compassionate Release Program, and this is normally done. There's three venues that a federal inmate may go into. If they have a life-threatening condition, cancer, leukemia, Lou Gehrig's disease, some life-threatening illness, we do a compassionate release, and if they're approved, we can get an immediate release. Another venue is, which was just recently added, is that if you have a family member at home, maybe a spouse, or maybe a child that's physically challenged. Maybe he's on a ventilator, he's in a wheelchair, and you are the sole caregiver for that individual, then you may be able to get into the compassionate release this way. The newest area are for elderly inmates who have been in prison over 10 years or 50% of their sentence, and they have medical conditions that they're maybe not life-threatening, but they're not going to improve in prison. There's no treatment in prison is going to help them improve, and they're costing the Bureau of Prisons money and medically costing the Bureau of Prisons. Those people are also eligible, and we do quite a few of those also. But all of the four sentence reduction programs are good programs for us simply because they help the individual, they help the prison, and they help the family. Everything is tied into the family unit.